Hello YouTube, RJ. Hey, I've been posting videos on equipment that I've been purchasing to build up the bench to work on high voltage tube equipment, vintage equipment. Had a lot of questions on it. They really generated a lot of interest in the comments about safety and what was right and what was wrong. First thing is, learned a lot on this. Worked out great for me. I was under the belief that this was a transformer that had a secondary winding that you interacted with, you tapped off of to get different ratios. Turns out that no, this only has one winding. So there's only one winding to protect. So the fuse here is protecting the single winding that's in there. The winding is rated at 20 amps and they've got a 20 amp fuse in here. In the video where I showed the wiring and such in there, everything looked good. But a lot of people were very, very concerned that I was going to hook up and this wasn't going to protect me because I was going to pull lower voltages, which would pull higher amperage while putting less, you know, amperage here and not pulling the fuse. There was a lot of concern. I was going to do all these things and it's going to be dangerous and such. And so this video is to put everything together, show you how it is intended to be used, how I intend to use my equipment, and how it works together to build a safe system on the bench and hopefully calm those concerns. So what we have here is, if you haven't watched the video, it's a 2 kVA auto transformer variable Variac unit that allows me to vary the voltage up and down, AC voltage. This is an isolation transformer, and if you hang on to the end of the video, I'm going to open this up and let us take a look inside. One of my viewers commented they would really like to see how this is put together internally, so we're going to take it apart at the end of the video and let everybody see what it looks like inside. So that's coming. So this is an isolation transformer. The purpose of the isolation transformer is to isolate me, and I misspoke in the video. I said that it isolated me from the ground. It does that, but I said ground twice. What I meant was it isolates me galvanically from the actual mains I'm connected to. So I have no neutral and no ground connection with this. When you put it in the special switch position that I showed, it disconnects both ground and the mains, neutral and hot. If you put it in the normal, it leaves the ground pass through. So I run this in the special. That way, we're totally isolated. We have nothing passing through. There was concerns that, hey, what if you have a ground fault, then it's going to be an issue. No, because ground doesn't pass through. There's no ground to ground fault too. The only thing you get out of here is a hot and neutral, and they're galvanically isolated. They have no interaction at all with the mains that you're powering your shop with, your lab. So the other device you've seen was my dim bulb tester. Its purpose is pretty simple. It is a current limiter that lets me see if I'm pulling quite a bit of current. It makes sure that if I have a short or a cap that's shorted in a device that I'm testing, that I've got a load that will prevent everything from going really bad, things blowing up, high current flows, that kind of thing. This is going to limit how much current can flow through because it's in series. So even if I have a dead short, the most I could really pull through here would be, you know, 100 watts, because this light bulb's intended to be directly on the main. So with these working together, what you've got is your variable voltage, which then gets isolated. You can do this both ways. Some people like it one way, some people like it the other way. I prefer to have my isolation after my Variac, because you'll see in a minute, it gives me the ability to monitor everything very, you know, you'll see some people build their dim bulbs with current meters and voltage and all that. I have this built into my isolator transformer, so when I'm bringing things up and I'm testing things, I can actually see. Now, to answer the question about what happens if you try to pull too much current from here, well, what if you're not on the dim bulb, and what if you hook up to something and maybe it's working and you take it off the dim bulb and all of a sudden a capacitor shorts to ground and you get a big current run? You're going to damage the windings in this. Well, no, the reason that's not going to happen is because the isolation transformer has a circuit breaker in it, and that circuit breaker is rated at 10 amps. So the most that I could pull without popping a circuit breaker would be 10 amps out of this unit. So since the winding is rated at 20, at any voltage that I put it at, I should be safe at 10 amps, because Maybe I could pull more than 20 amps at a low voltage, but not if a circuit breaker is on that system. So when people kept saying you have to have a fuse on the secondary or on the output, I do. I have it right here. The only thing that could happen is this thing go bad and short. Well, you can't protect against everything. Then I would just have to rely on this popping. So I've got a 10 amp circuit breaker. So the most I can pull is 10 amps. That's not a limiting factor to me. Most all equipment I'll be working on is antique radios that pull, 30 watts or a quarter amp. A jukebox that might pull 300-400 watts. So nothing that's going to get near 10 amps. So we should be perfectly safe working with this. I've over here, I've got my soldering tweezers. It's not a dead short, but it's simulates pretty good, close to a short. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to show you how it works. So if I bring on my Variac, power it up, and turn on my isolation transformer, you can see that I'm getting 16.9 volts out of here at 0.07 amps, 90.95 watts. This I haven't reset. It says I've pulled 0.06 kilowatt hours through this since I've started using it. I'm getting 59.9 hertz at 1.00 power factor. Okay. Now my dim bulb needs to be turned on. So let's turn the dim bulb on. Okay. Now you can see we've got an increase in power output. So you can see I'm only getting 17 volts roughly. So if I start bringing the voltage up, what's going to happen is the current's going to start coming up. Voltage is going to start coming up. The dim bulb's going to start light. Okay. Because there's a lot of current being drawn, and I can adjust my voltage from a Variac very accurately right here. I can bring it up, say 120 volts, let's say. Okay, 120 volts, 121. We're pulling 0.68 amps, 85 watts, 0.06 kilowatt hours, which that'll clock up over time. 59.9 still, 1.03 power factor. So the dim bulb tells me I'm pulling quite a bit of current. This is not quite enough power to actually, it's limited enough that this cannot operate correctly. Once I know that, I say, okay, we know that this is working correctly. There's nothing dead shorted. This case, it would look like we have quite a bit of current. We can look here and see 83.2 watts. I know what this is supposed to pull. That's way below what it's supposed to pull. So what we can do then is we can turn everything off. I can remove the dim bulb from the circuit, plug it straight in, getting rid of my current limiting. And now when I bring it back on, this is going to come up and function because it's getting the current it needs. You can see it's pulling 150 watts. It's getting 120 volts. It's pulling 1.03 amps. I've got a nice meter to monitor what my load is doing. I've got the ability to bring the voltage up slowly. I've got a current limiter to protect me if I've got something shorted or something goes awry. So obviously this stuff won't be on the bench while I'm doing this. It'll be over on the other bench over here, but for filming, I've got it up here. So when I'm working on this bench with high voltage stuff, I'll have this over here, making sure that I'm safe, I'm isolated, and I can control the voltage and I can limit the current if I'm testing. So that's the whole idea. This is how it all works together. And this is how I've got fusing, if you will, on the output of this. With that, I'm going to break. I'm going to come back. And then we're going to open this up and see what's inside. Be right back. Okay, we're back. I've readjusted the cameras and set up. We're going to tear it apart. Let's see what's in this thing. I can speed it up a little with my electric screwdriver, but being these screws are that short, don't know that it's worth the time. It's fairly chunky. Has a little heft to it. Assuming that's quite a reasonable sized toroid transformer inside here. Okay, not hard to get apart. Get the top set over here. So yeah, we've got a pretty good sized toroidal transformer in here. Hopefully you can see. Spin around here and let you see the back. I've showed this during the other video where I introduced it. Your power cord input, universal European and American plugs for the back. Not real wild about them, but they work okay. This is the switch I was talking about. You have a standard and a special mode. Standard allows the ground to pass through, continues to pass the ground through. The special cuts off the ground so that you have nothing from the line side, the supply side passes through to the output. This thing is a 1 kV rated. It's not as heavy as my Variac. You can see the cables are a little smaller gauge, but still looks sufficient for 10 amps. It's a fairly neat, compact unit. You can see they're just using one of those modules like I've used in things where, you know, it's a integrated little module for your voltage and current. And it has the 10 amp circuit breaker here. It has, to help with noise, it's got a ferrite. If you can make this out here, let me see if I can get it where you see. You look right down in there, see the ferrite at the bottom down there? There's a ferrite on one of the lines. I'm sure that's an RF noise thing to help keep noise from driving this crazy. But I mean, it's pretty simple. It's just a one-to-one transformer with a primary and a secondary winding. As you can see, you know, correct this time. It is a primary and secondary. Basically, it's taking whatever you put in, passing it right back out, but it's magnetically coupled. So you have, you know, you've got that magnetic separation of the supplies. Looks like they did a fairly neat job. I can't really say anything super negative. I can see the ground. The grounding from the input is connected to the case here. So we are grounded there. And that's it. So thanks for tuning in. Hope you learned something. So hope to see you on the next video. We'll be getting into some projects coming up. That's what all this is leading up to, is some additional projects. So thanks for tuning in.